we need to turn our phones off on flights?
Absolutely
right?
Not. Just annoys the pilots. But you tell us more.
Yeah, I feel like pilot annoyance. I was more like, does it do anything at all? Because I was like, pilot annoyance would be fairly high on my list of, I don't want to annoy the pilot. I want them to be focused on flying and shit.
Yeah. Well, I don't actually know why. I did once speak to a pilot about this, and he told me the answer, but it was a long time ago. So,
well, good news. I'm not a pilot, but I will tell you the answer.
Tell me the answer.
I actually flew on... You know, you can fly direct from Prague to Beijing, which is pretty cool.
That's long.
It wasn't too bad.
That's a long flight.
It's like 9 hours, 10 hours. Maybe it was long. It's probably 11 hours.
I don't know. I did London. I did London to Beijing actually. So
it's going
to
be a couple of hours longer.
12 hours maybe, or 13 hours. Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, and I flew because there's loads of Chinese tourists in Prague, of course, and it's this Chinese airline called Hainan. Maybe I flew on it, and I don't even know. Uh-huh. And they're like, dude. There, you know, turn your phone off at takeoff and turn it back on when you land. And I'm like, and not just, you know, airplane mode.
Yeah.
Off.
Off.
And I'm like, what am I supposed to do? Watch your crappy movies on the in-flight entertainment. I've downloaded like 6 seasons of Breaking Bad onto Netflix to watch. It's 13 hours or whatever. And so I was like, oh, this is just bullshit. So I just take out my phone, you know, I'm watching Netflix on my phone, and the flight attendant lady comes by and she's like, please turn off your phone, sir. And I'm like, Yeah, I'll turn off my phone. So she goes away and I turn it back on again. Because I'm like, oh, it's just stupid policy. And then she comes back and she tells me like 3 times. And I'm like, okay. And then I just get the blanket, put it over my head, and I'm just like watching it.
I'm asleep. Yeah.
But apparently...
While sitting on your hands.
They take it really seriously. And I've got this quote here. In 2014, the European Aviation Safety Agency announced that electronic devices were not safety risks, so we know that. Mm. But the agencies of other countries, such as the Federal Aviation Administration, the FAA of the United States, and the Civil Aviation Administration of China, they've kept the limits in place. In China, electronic devices must be kept off for the duration of the flight. So it wasn't just a Hainan Airlines policy, or however you say it, or the users face the possibility of a short stay in jail.
You could have gone to prison.
Or several $1,000 in fines.
You could have gone to prison
in
China.
I mean, I'd definitely pay the fine rather than go to Chinese goddamn prison. I mean, the next thing I know, I'd be like, yeah, we've decided to donate your kidney to a party member. I'm like, oh, God.
So what does it do?
Okay, so basically the problem is, like, there can be some interference. So, yeah, it's, you know, it's obviously looking for cell towers even when you're in the air, because it's like, oh God, where are my cell towers?
Frequent listeners of this show will know the sound. This is a...
Yeah, wow. God damn it. I didn't turn my phone off for like 3 episodes in a row. Now... We have a checklist like NASA that we go through every time.
And you know, somehow, even with the checklist, I've now just walked over with my
phone. I saw your phone going off. Like, it's because I didn't ask you. I've got to print you a checklist.
Although, I think actually what happened was I was on the Wi-Fi in airplane mode, so it was a WhatsApp.
That's fine. You can have that.
I can have a WhatsApp,
It won't fuss if you've just got the Wi-Fi on.
Thank God for that. There you go.
So that's good. And I'm going to laminate these, I think. I'm going to get a laminator.
Should we put them up?
Because I ruined like 4 of them, because I've got them at home as well. I've got my home checklist.
Okay.
I've got really into checklists.
You like checklists?
Yeah, yeah. And I had a massive cup of this same... flu medicine, yeah. And I spilled it all over my desk.
No,
ruined my checklists, all over my laptop, which by some miracle survived, because that's how I killed my last one.
What? Cough mixture?
No, just a cup of coffee spilled all over it.
That's devastating.
Dude, I got to tell you, this cup, it was a stupid cup.
Okay.
It was an idiotic cup.
Okay, yeah.
It was a terrible cup.
It was a bad cup.
Yeah, I mean. In 100 years, people are going to listen back to this and be like, oh my God, Simon, I can't believe you were so against cups. They have rights. And this cup was just, it was from IKEA, so you'd think they'd have it together. But Sonic it was cup. Just really narrow at the base and big on top.
Ah, oh, terrible.
And so I just knocked it over, and then it ruined my laptop,
which
was expensive.
There's 2 things I hate in a mug or a cup. I know this is terrible, Pod, but one is a narrow bottom. And a large top, and like a large top, so it falls over. So it's not balanced at all.
I love how you're like, I'm going to tell Simon's story again and describe it as terrible.
No. The other, which I received, which I got given, was a perfectly round, like circular, sort of conclave top. Because that way, when you drink it, it will all sort of spill out the sides.
Who designs this?
Yeah, I don't know. Idiots. That's who they are.
The thing is, there's not going to be any problems because airplanes, you know, they're really well shielded because interference,
It's everywhere.
Can you imagine if a mobile phone crashed a plane? Have you ever heard of this?
What, no. With no.
With the interference? Of course not. It's like petrol stations, gas stations for our American friends. When yes. you go in, it's like, turn off your mobile phones. Or don't be on mobile phones. Because I think there was once a petrol station blew up while someone was on the phone in the petrol station. They were like, well, that's not good.
They said it was like static, didn't they? Or something like that. What's the...
I think it was like a spot. There could have been... This probably isn't what happens, but theoretically what could have happened is there were gas fumes in the air and there was a spark within the mobile phone and this ignited the fumes. But it's not what happened.
Turn off your
really
mobile
unlikely.
Phone when you...
Don't.
When you... what do you call it? Putting gas in the tank.
Don't. Just use it and be really subtle about it so you don't get in trouble. Yeah, like me on the plane.
Wear headphones.
Using it under the blanket.
Just get under a blanket.
Yeah, just get under you're filling up your just car under a blanket.
Under a blanket.
I said important business call. Sell. Yeah, so basically you're absolutely right, Sam.
Uh-huh.
You spoiled it at the beginning.
Sorry.
It's just all about pilot annoyance. It just annoys the pilots.
And is it just beep, beep, beeps? Or could they hear into your conversation? Could they listen into your conversation? Or
pretty certain they can't hear you. Also, you're on a plane. How are you going to have a conversation?
Well, by going under a blanket and calling.
Where you're not going to get any reception.
Yeah.
I mean, you will right at the beginning.
True. But like, for instance...
Also, if you're having a phone call on a plane, people are going to look at you funny.
However, you say that. However, when planes are going down, they often say, call your loved ones. Like, they say, like, call your loved ones, send them a message, things like that. Like, not like if it's... They know something is wrong. There was that one, wasn't there? Like, 3 years ago or something, where they said, we know we're going to crash. Like, send messages to your family and friends.
No.
Yeah. I cannot think at all what it was. It was the name of the flight.
But anyway, you can get reception, but only quite close to the ground. Because, I don't know, I never bothered turning my phone onto airplane mode. Because then also...
Sounds like you have terrible plane etiquette. You sit on your hands, you've got your...
sitting on your hands is... The worst plane etiquette is when you fall asleep on someone else.
Or do you know the worst plane etiquette? The worst...
Taking your shoes off.
Not just shoes off.
Socks
shoes off,
off,
socks off, and then feet up.
You've got your feet up, yeah, something is
that's
wrong
how
with you. Taking your socks off, taking your shoes off is like...
It's like punishable, but it's okay. It's on the edge.
Yeah, look, if the plane's providing socks, you can take your socks off. You know, in the... vanity kits.
Yeah.
If they're not, let's just keep our shoes on.
Shoes on.
Let's just not ruin it for everyone.
No one. Yeah. Smelly places, planes.
Yeah, but the air's always fresh.
I don't know.
Did we talk about this before?
I don't know if I think actually the opposite. Wasn't it the case that
if you think the opposite, you're wrong.
No, but isn't it the case that the air was fresher when you could smoke because they had to filter the air?
No, they don't filter it. They just push new air in.
Use fresh air. Yeah.
Because even though you're at altitude and there's not much oxygen in the air, they just scoop a load of air in and then they compress it to the right atmosphere and they bring it in. The air on a plane is replaced every like 3 minutes or something.
Really? Okay, wow.
It's fresher than the air in this office.
Do you know how long you can survive consciously?
20 seconds.
What was my question?
How long?
If cabin pressure,
yeah,
cabin pressure
exactly.
drops.
What else is your question going to be?
I think they say 7 seconds, I think it is. A friend of mine's a pilot for we won't name the Irish airline, but...
Aer Lingus.
No, the other one.
Ryanair. Michael O'Leary. I only know this because I was watching that, I mentioned it last episode, 7-4 Crew, the guy who does this YouTube channel
as a
pilot. And I think he was saying, he was doing the... review of the Tom Hanks movie Castaway.
Okay.
And
great
there's
movie.
The plane... Great movie.
Great movie.
The plane crashes and he's saying like the pilot puts the mask on Tom Hanks first before putting him on himself.
Massive
and
mistake.
He says... Yeah. He says you always put your own mask on first because you've only got like 20 seconds of useful consciousness.
Yeah, a bit of unconsciousness is not going to kill someone. Let them pass out and then help
them.
Then
put their mask on afterwards, exactly, and they'll come back
That's
around.
That's why they always say don't do your kids first, do yourself first.
Exactly.
You can help your kids, they can't help you really.
Right. I guess that's fine. Let's wrap this up. You can use your... I mean... Oh,
unless you're going
to
China.
My parents came to visit. And they were saying... Then when the plane was descending, they were saying like we're doing an instrument landing because it was incredibly foggy. So it asked you to actually please put your phones on airplane mode.
Oh, really?
And I don't know why. I didn't look it up. I just remember that story right now.
Maybe it's just absolute focus, like absolute no interruptions, you know, no distraction in case there's any beep beep beep.
Got to be scary though. Can you actually turn your phones off? We need to concentrate on landing the plane because we're, you know,
we can't see.
We're not super great at it, and we need to focus.
Was I discussing it with you that they did a whole load of someone, I think in America, they did a whole load of autopilot tests landing an airplane, and they landed it on the same spot so many times that they began to indent the ground.
Yeah, I looked it up. I couldn't find anything backing it up. It sounded like a myth to me. Oh. So I looked it up and I couldn't find anything.
Oh, I love a myth. But okay, all right, I will try and find something because I'm pretty sure that happened.
We will see.